What was one yet?
Yeah, would you remember about writing it?
So we wrote this one together. It was in the springtime, wasn't it? When we were just kind of easing up from lockdown. Like, we're obviously in Scotland. Scotland lockdown has been probably a lot tougher than what's going on in the US and other parts of the world. So we kind of wanted a song to be in the moment when everyone's getting back together, everyone's having a good time, but not mention coronavirus or the kind of struggles of the last year, but hint at that in the song with some of the lyrics.
I think people had enough of that. And we're putting a positive spin on it. Yeah. Plus, if you remember from even back then, it's been unbelievably great weather in Scotland from early from spring right through till now, and every day we'd say, let's get some people over, get a few drinks when the lockdown finishes.
I mean, we had a bunch of songs written, we had loads of songs ready to go, but one thing I think is really important is the timing of songs and when certain songs are coming out, and it felt like the time to put them on the back burner and write something specific for this summer. My producer Andy sent over a track maybe early springtime. It's just a backing track that I'd been working on. It had this really upbeat sort of feel to the chorus, and I heard the kind of chorus production and I immediately was like, right, we need to do something with this, we need to turn this into a single. So we kept the vibe of that chorus and then completely rewrote the production and the sort of verses and everything else. We actually wrote the first verse with different melodies and different lyrics maybe two or three times.
We did.
It took us, you know, we just wanted to set the tone immediately and it just wasn't happening, so went back, wrote it again, and finally got the melody and the lyrics that we were looking for.
I think the chorus was always there, wasn't it?
The chorus and the song title. The song title itself, obviously it's about the weather and it's about the heat, but we didn't write it specifically as that. We wanted the double meaning of it being the best one yet. So like the middle eight, for example, is Joey.
Hey Joey,
coming up.
What did you...
The middle eight, when it's talking about the sun not shining, etc., it's not really about the weather, because we don't really get that here, so we wanted to keep it that when the sun isn't shining, it's about it being the best summer yet. That's what we mean by hottest. It's not so much about the...
Yes. Joey agrees.
The heat coming through. I probably just blabbed a lot of crap right now because he's there.
I think for me as well, I think one of the important elements of the record that nobody ever really speaks about in records or don't speak of enough is the actual sound of the record, I think. I think once we nailed the lyrics and the feel of it, then I think a lot of it is down to how the overall record sounds. I think the production's great on it. But you adding that extra little guitar thing, the verses.
Yeah, but it was weird because we never ever changed the tempo of the track, but the verse did feel like it was lagging a little bit.
Yeah.
You only get like 5 or 10 seconds these days to get people into it if it doesn't feel like it's picking up pace immediately.
Yeah.
So the little... I just came up with that on like a MIDI guitar on Logic, sent it down to Andy, Andy played it in. And even having something that was almost like double speed just made the whole track.
Yeah.
It gave the whole track momentum.
Yeah, I think because it didn't have a big giant, you know, bombastic intro.
Yeah.
So you had to have something straight away
to
make people feel this is probably a bit faster than it is.
Yeah. I always say to people, when you get to the middle eight, you've got two options. You can either come right down.
Yeah.
Or you can take it up one more notch.
Yeah, you've done that
and
as
I
well.
I actually had an alternative way that I wanted to go with the middle eight that wasn't quite as... It was a little bit more laid back than what it is now. Mm. And it was Andy that actually said to us, no, we're going to push it. And I think he started playing a little bit of what the melody is now, of where he had an idea of where it could go. Mm. And as soon as I heard that, I was like, right, that's exactly what we need to do. It needed to take that extra step up.
Yeah. But and then I also like the kind of the old Ferra Jaca at the end chorus, just to give it an extra little...
The verse lyrics, but in chorus form.
Yeah, in chorus, which works.
Yeah, now you'd specifically said to try and do something like that.
Yeah.
Every single ad-lib, every single detail in that song is exactly how I'd want it to be. That was the one thing I was worried about, because we were on a time limit. We needed the song out for July.
Yeah.
If you didn't get it out for July, you'd miss summer season.
Yeah.
Like, really.
Though it seems to be going on and on and on here.
Whereas sometimes we'll sit with songs for months, but we couldn't do that with this. So it was really, we're on a proper time limit, and music artists will know that you need to get stuff to distribution and stuff, like weeks and weeks and weeks in advance. So, but we did it, and I'm delighted with it, and being able to just create a song for everyone to enjoy this summer that reflects on what's happened, but not completely talking about, you know, COVID and, you know, the people we've lost and all that kind of stuff, but celebrating the people that, you know, are still with us and the things that we are now able to do again for the first time in a long time. So and it's just one of those ones at festivals as well. We played it a couple of weeks ago and people can just get on board with it and have a good time and dance. And
well, you see them shuffle along to quite the thing straight away before even hearing it a lot of the time, and that's a sign of a good track, you know. So that worked. The video was great fun as well, and it made the video for it.
Yeah,
it's sunny.
We were proper struggling with a video because you were saying to me that we need to do some sort of video for it. Mm. and I never liked doing videos unless I can bring justice to the song. Mm. I was like, what on earth are we going to do? We're going to have to do some sort of lyric video so that it doesn't look like we're doing a massive big production video that probably won't be as good, because we had like 3 weeks to get everything organised for it, because the song was coming out. And in Scotland, you cannot guarantee any sort of weather at all.
No.
So it's apart finding this year. The worst part is not finding a cast, it's not finding a location or something to do it in, it's the weather.
Yeah.
That's the number one priority when you're trying to organise something here. So we just kind of lucked out on it, to be honest.
Yeah.